mule deer are good neighbors. They don't get into things. They don't disrupt anything, and they're part of nature. They were here long before we were. I'm Lenox Baker, and I'm the owner of the Pitchfork Ranch. We're located 18 miles west of Meteetse, right on the edge of the Absaroka Mountains, and Yellowstone is just over the hills. Stuff that migrates out of Yellowstone, including grizzlies and wolves, this is where they're coming. I have 20 or 30 mule deer that spend a lot of time in my front yard. They sleep under there under the trees. It's nice having them around. We don't think of what it takes to maintain their health. We've seen the numbers go way down from where 3 or 4 years ago they looked quite unhealthy.
If you look at some of the historical data for this herd unit, it has declined over the past 20, 30 years. A lot of factors out there, drought conditions, poor habitat conditions, and we're trying what we can to increase numbers, but it just gets more difficult year after year, and numbers just seem to be kind of static right now at low densities of deer.
If we can let them migrate where they want to, that's a much healthier life for them. They don't get trapped into places where they lose weight, and we lose them because of environmental conditions. They're doing a lot of collaring here of the animals and starting to learn a lot about the migration, because we really don't know near what we need to know about where they actually migrate and when they migrate.
There was a study back in the 1980s. It was without the current technology, but we did have two deer that ended up in Du Bois from here. That's probably 30 air miles, which is a good indication that some deer are traveling quite a long distance.
We just were coloring deer earlier today, and it was fascinating to me to watch the teamwork that was developed from the helicopter, brought them in, landed beautifully, and quickly 8 or 10 biologists working on this deer in a period of 15 minutes. We learned all their, their fat levels, the fact that they're pregnant, and then the deer is released carefully, and they run back up the hill. I think it's a very important thing for ranchers to get involved with. We need to be part of the solution of the problem of not blocking off migration routes. And this primarily comes up with our fencing. You can easily fence in places that'll handle your cattle without interfering with migration. It's just knowing how to keep maybe the top strand lower and the lower strand higher. It's as little as that. I kind of look at my time. I'm lucky to own this, but I'm just here for a short period of time in the big scheme of things. And I think when we're here, it's important not to create things that disrupt the naturalness of this place. And all this can coexist if you just kind of plan for it and think about it.